Yet. Hallelujah.
Waiting for change to come.
Yes, hallelujah.
Knowing the battle's won. For you have never failed me yet. Promise still stands. Great is your faithfulness. Faithfulness. I'm still in your hands. This is my confidence. You've never failed me yet. Faithfulness. I'm still in your hands.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, we worship you. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah, we worship you. Oh, we magnify. Oh, hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
You've never failed.
Yes.
I never will forget.
Come on, just worship him. Just magnify him. Hallelujah, in this time of uncertainties and everything that we're facing, hallelujah. Oh, everything we, hallelujah, we face, hallelujah. We come before you with thanksgiving, Lord God, hallelujah. Trusting in you, Lord God. Oh, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. We reverence you. Oh, Lord God, you are gracious, sufficient. Oh, hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Oh, Father God, even right now, Lord God, we believe that you make it way. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Why don't you rest in this moment? Hallelujah, hallelujah. Come on, just give him your heart of worship. Oh, just send out a shout of praise where you are. Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. You move mountains. Oh, Jehovah, Jehovah.
I see you.
We see you. Do it again. Hallelujah. Oh,
there is no way. And I believe. I see you do it.
Hallelujah.
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 I see you do it again.
Made a way. Yeah.
When there was no way.
And I believe. Hallelujah.
I see you do it again.
Hallelujah. Just have your way, Lord. Have your way. Have your way. Not my will. Not my will, but thine be done. As your people are gathered, Lord God, and they're in need of a way. What we believe.
I see you do it again. You move the mountains.
Yeah.
I see you do it again. You made a way where there was no way.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, we just magnify your name. We just magnify your name. We just reverence you, oh Lord, almighty God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Oh, I magnify your name, Lord God. You are worthy to be praised from the rising of the sun to the going down of the same. Your name is worthy to be praised. Oh, we just look to you today, Lord God, hallelujah, as we played and we've listened to the song that tells us, Lord God, hallelujah, that your promises still stand. Lord God, hallelujah, this confidence that we have in you, Lord God, that you will see us through, Lord God. We believe that you are a way maker, and we believe that you are a miracle working God. So, Father God, as we come before you on this morning, Lord God, faced with so much uncertainties and faced with all different kind of things that we are facing, Lord God, we're standing on your promises and we're standing on your word. And it tells us, Lord God, hallelujah, that when we come together, if we come together and two or three are gathered, Lord God, hallelujah, and touching on anything that's concerning you, Lord God, you will show up in the midst, Lord. And Father God, even though we are not gathered together, even though we're not able to physically touch each other, Lord God, but Father God, you've given us, Lord, you've given us our voice, our communication, Lord God, that we can touch together, Lord God, in agreement and knowing, Lord God, that if we believe you in the spiritual realms and if we trust you, Lord God, no matter what we're facing and no matter what we're dealing with, no matter what the situation and the circumstances may be on today, Lord God, that you will show up on our behalf. So, Father God, I pray, Lord God, oh, for those that are, everyone that's listening, Lord God, and Lord God, hallelujah. Oh, Father God, oh, I thank you because, oh, just dropped in my spirit that you know all about our troubles, Lord. You will guide us till the day is done. There is not a friend like you, Jesus. So, Father God, we are in need of you right now. We are in search of you right now, hallelujah. Oh, Father God, if you don't do it for us, Lord, hallelujah, it cannot be done, Lord. And as we are living in a time of uncertainties and we've seen, Lord God, of different kind of civil unrest and different kind of things, Lord God, that we are dealing with and we are facing with, Lord God, this pandemic, Lord, that seems, Lord God, that when we thought it would have started to fade away, it seems like it's coming back full force. But Father God, in the name of Jesus, we know, Lord God, that you can keep us, Lord God, that you can sustain us, Lord God. Oh, Father God, as we are here, Lord God, and so many are on this, oh, Lord God, Facebook live feed at the other end of this live feed, Lord God, and you know, Lord God, that they are in need. Oh, Father God, their back is against the wall, and they feel like throwing in the towel. They feel like giving up, Lord God. But, Father God, in the name of Jesus, I pray, Lord God, that you'll break every chain of oppression, Lord God. I pray, Lord God, that you'll roll back oppression, Lord God. Oh, Father God, even, Lord God, for lack, Lord God, hallelujah. Oh, for those, Lord God, that are, Lord God, in need of a spiritual awakening even on this morning, Lord God. I pray, Lord God, that you will visit them, Lord God, that you will quicken them, Lord God, that you will touch them, Lord God, that you will reach them at the point of their need, Lord God, hallelujah. Oh, Father God, because we know that this is the hour has come when, Lord God, your people shall come up, Lord God, hallelujah, and call upon you, Lord God, and it doesn't matter, Lord God, where they are, they may not be able to go on a physical mountaintop, but Father God, in the name of Jesus, that you will take them, you will elevate them in spirit, Lord God. Oh, Father God, in the name of Jesus, and I'm just thankful of your grace, and thankful, Lord God, at all that you have done, and all that you are planning to do, Lord God. Oh, in the name of Jesus, we need you, we need you. If there's any time that we need you, is now, Lord God, when men's hearts are failing, Lord God. Oh, in the name of Jesus, we need you, we need you, we need you, we need you. Oh, Father God, hallelujah, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah, we thank you, Jesus. Oh, hallelujah, and as we play this song, hallelujah. Oh, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus.
Before I spoke a word.
Oh, we worship you, Almighty God. Hallelujah. Oh, we thank you, God.
You have been so,
so good to us, Lord God. And services doesn't look as conventional as they used to be, Lord God. But Father God, we worship you, Lord God. Yeah, amen, 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 amen.
You have been so, so kind.
Oh, Father God, have your way, Lord God.
You're the overwhelming, never-ending, breathless love, God. Oh, it chases me down, fights till I'm found.
Leaves
the 99, and I couldn't earn it. I don't deserve it. Still, you give yourself away.
All the
overwhelming, never ending, breathless love.
Hallelujah.
There's no wall you won't kick down, now you won't kick down.
want to read this scripture to us. It's out of Luke 15. Sometimes people get confused by it, but I feel like the Lord's all over it tonight. I want to read it to us. It says, now the tax collectors and sinners are all gathering around to hear Jesus. The Pharisees and teachers of the law mutter, this man welcomes the sinners and eats with them. The religious people are mad.
Hallelujah.
It sets the stage and Jesus pipes up. He told them this parable. It says, suppose one of you has 100 sheep and loses one of them. Doesn't he leave the 99 in the open country and go after the lost sheep until he finds it? And after he finds it, he joyfully puts it on his shoulders and he goes home. He calls his friends, he calls his neighbors together and says, rejoice with me because I've found my lost sheep. And I tell you that in the same way, there will be more rejoicing in heaven over one sinner who repents than over 99 righteous people who don't. Man, he's that good. I want to just read a couple thoughts, just share a little bit of the story behind this song, and then we'll sing that bridge one more time and we'll go nuts. We'll see what happens. So when I use the phrase, the reckless love of God, when we say it, we're not saying that God himself is reckless. He's not crazy. We are, however, saying that the way he loves is in many regards quite so. But what I mean is this. He's utterly unconcerned with the consequences of his actions with regard to his own safety, comfort, and well-being. His love isn't crafty or slick. It's not cunning or shrewd. In fact, all things considered, it's quite childlike. And might I even suggest sometimes downright ridiculous. His love bankrupted heaven for you, for me. His love doesn't consider himself first. It isn't selfish or self-serving. He doesn't wonder what he'll gain or lose by putting himself on the line. He simply puts himself out there on the off chance that you and I might look back at him and give him that love in return. His love leaves the 99 to find the one every time. And to many practical adults, that's a foolish concept. But what if he loses the 99 in finding the one, right? What if? Finding that one lost sheep is and will always be supremely important. His love isn't cautious. It's a love that sent his own son to die a gruesome death on a cross. There's no plan B with the love of God. He gives his heart so completely, so preposterously, that if refused, we would think it irreparably broken. Yet he gives himself away again.
Hallelujah.
And again,
thank you, Jesus.
And again, and again, time and time again. Make no mistake, our sins do pain his heart, and 70 times 7 is a lot of times to get your heart broken. And yet he opens up and allows us back in every single time. His love saw you when you hated him, and all logic said they'll reject me. He said, no, I don't care what it costs me. I lay my life on the line as long as I get their hearts. To make it personal, his love saw me, broken down kid, with regret as deep as the ocean. My innocence and youth poured out like water. And he found me and he put me on his shoulders. And he carried me on. Because he's just that good. He's just that kind. He's a father that never gives up. So as we sing this bridge and chorus one more time, just let it break down those walls tonight. There's no shadow. There's no shadow you won't light up, mountain you won't climb up, coming after me. Yeah. There's no wall you won't kick down, lie you won't tear down, coming after me. Yeah, again. There's no shadow you won't light up, mountain you won't climb up, coming after me. He's breaking off self-hatred tonight. There's no wall you won't kick down, lie you won't tear down, coming after. There's no shadow now. There's no shadow you won't light up, mountain you won't. Come on, let it rise. There's no wall you won't kick down, lie you won't tear down. Come on, declare no shadow now. There's no shadow you won't light up,
mountain you won't climb up, coming after me. Come on, just worship him. Hallelujah. Won't keep that. I won't keep that. I'm coming after me. Love. Hallelujah. We thank you, Jesus. We thank you, Almighty God. We thank you, Lord God, that you are so loving, kind, and so, hallelujah, willing, Lord, to leave the 99 just to chase that one, Lord God. And we're thankful, Lord God. I wonder if anybody's thankful today. You could have been somewhere there, lost your mind, but the goodness of God is who kept you. He kept you, and he's the reason why you are here today. And despite the situation and despite the circumstances that you are facing and that we are facing and that we're dealing with, because truth be told, we all are dealing with something. Hallelujah. And that's why I want to share with you today on the topic, hallelujah, on the topic, a sermon series that was in my heart, inside my heart, hallelujah, the art of, and for this sermon topic, I choose, and it was led, hallelujah, to look at the art of waiting, hallelujah, the art of waiting. And truth be told, we all know what it is like to wait for something and wait. But I want to read to you this text before we get, hallelujah. Before we get into the sermon, hallelujah, reading from Isaiah 40, 28, and it reads as such: Have you never heard? Have you never understood? The Lord is the everlasting God. Reading from the New Living Translation: the creator of all the earth, he never grows weak or weary. No one can measure the depth of his understanding. He gives power to the weak and strength to the powerless. Even youth will become weak and tired, and young men will fall in exhaustion. But verse 31 says, but those who trust in the Lord will find new strength. They will soar high on wings like eagles. They will run and not grow weary. They shall walk and not faint. Hallelujah. Let me just read verse 31 again. And I like the way the New Living Translation puts it in a way that you can understand it. But I love the King James Version. Hallelujah. That says, but they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. Hallelujah. So we want to talk about the art of waiting on today. And hallelujah. I know, as I was saying before, that we know what it is to wait for something. Growing up, you know, you always waited for your birthday to get some things. You know, your mama, your mother promised you this or you promised you that on your birthday, and you couldn't wait, you know, and you would be good, and you you would do everything that, you know, clean up your room and wash the dishes, because you know that, you know, if you were to go to the left or go to the right, you know, you might forfeit those things that you're waiting for. And I don't know about anybody else, but growing up in a society, we look forward to birthdays, because when you never had sometimes you never had all of the things during the course of the year, but you know, when your birthday came, you know, you might be able to get extra privilege and money and gifts, and so you look forward to that, just the opportunity to go somewhere, to have a birthday party, to be able to even have the color TV in your room. And, you know, y'all don't know about that, but for some of us, we got the opportunity when our birthday came around, when we had the TV privilege, you know, at that time. You know, we're not like these kids now today, where you know, they have TVs and two and three TVs in their room, but we waited, and not only that, Christmas, when Christmas came about, you know, you knew when Christmas was upon you, you waited for some good things, you know, a good dinner, you know, money in your pocket, the presents, and if you were waiting for a different type of things, you know, like a TV and this and that, you had to wait for it, hallelujah, for your parents to bless you and to give you that, hallelujah. But the wait that I want to talk about today, we're talking about waiting on the Lord. Hallelujah. I know this year 2020 has been, we've been faced with so many obstacles, and we've been faced with, you know, when we left 2019, some of us were looking and we were thinking how great 2020 was going to be, and it's the year of the vision of the 2020, and your eyes are going to be opened up, and you're going to get double, and you're going to get this, and you're going to get that, and there is so many things that were declared over our lives, and we'd be this and we'd be that, we'd have two cars and three houses and all of these different things. But when the 2020 rolled around, well, some of the things that we were looking forward to didn't actually go as planned. I wonder if I have any witness that knew that 2020 was going to be the year of greatness and the great of being risen and lifted up in higher heights, and when 2020 came around, you just had this feeling like, yes, you know, I'm going to, this is going to be my year. But here it is, 2020 has come, and hallelujah, we are in the 11th month of the year 2020, and some of us, we've lost so many things during the course of this year 2020, and I can speak for myself, you know, I've lost my father, and that was hard in itself, and having to deal with everything that we have to deal with, you know, the economy, and dealing with, you know, choosing the election and the presidency and everything that we are waiting to see the outcome. But hallelujah, I am just so thankful that we might have had our ways, and we might have thought about this, and we might have had one plan in our mind. But I just want to tell you that, you know, the waiting that we ought to be waiting on is waiting on God. Hallelujah. We're living in a season where so many things are failing. The hearts of men are failing left and right, center. Hallelujah. And I truly believe that the year 2020 was the year of the rude awakening for some. I know for some that the year has gone, and you've had, you know, besides the pandemic, things have been going good. You may have had one stimulus, you may have had two stimulus, you've been fed, and you've been going through this, and you've been going through that, and but God is still keeping you. And I'm just thankful that even in the midst of this pandemic, even in the midst of everything that we're going through, hallelujah, my God is still kept us, and he still kept me, he still kept my family. But what about you? How are you feeling today? How are you feeling today? Hallelujah. With everything that you are facing, with everything that you're dealing with, everything that's going on with you, how are you feeling today? Hallelujah. Some people have been waiting all their lives, and they've been waiting for, you know, to get married, and they've been waiting for the perfect job. They've been waiting for, you know, the perfect house with the picket fence. They've been waiting to have children. They've been waiting, hallelujah, for so many good things and so many things during the course of their lives. And they're at a place where the, my God, hallelujah, I've waited for so long, and I have not been able to see the fulfillment of everything, hallelujah, that I thought that I would see. But I'm here to remind somebody that we have a Savior who is bigger than any mountains that we are facing. We serve a God that we can look to. No wonder the psalmist David says in Psalms 46 that God is my refuge and strength. I want to encourage somebody today that God is your refuge. He is your strength. Hallelujah. He is your fortress. He is your deliverer. He is your healer. He is your protector. He's your Savior. So no matter what you are facing, I want you to glean off of this topic, glean off the scripture, and you can read it for yourself. Psalms 46, that God is your refuge, and He's your strength, and He's a very present help in times of trouble. So if you are facing a moment of trouble, a moment of uncertainties, and I'm sure we all are facing that, I want to encourage somebody today that He is your refuge. I want to encourage somebody this morning that you should trust Him. Trust him, even though you're going through it, even though you may not know your way out, you may not be able to see your way out, hallelujah, but I want to tell somebody, I want to encourage somebody, hallelujah, to trust in God with all your heart, and lean not onto your own understanding, but in all your ways acknowledge Him, and He will direct your path this morning. I want to encourage somebody this morning that you may be feeling down, you may be feeling burdened, you may be in a low place, you may be feeling, hallelujah, that life is just beating you left and beating you right. But I want to tell somebody, hallelujah, as according to Psalms 121, that says, I will lift up my eyes unto the hills, from whence cometh my help. So if you're in that place this morning, I just want to tell somebody, lift up your eyes to the hills, for whence your help is coming, and knowing and trusting that your help comes from God. Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. I love it. I love it. I love it. Because verse 2 says, my help comes from the Lord, which makes heaven and earth. So you know that you trust in the Lord. Hallelujah. Oh, we could just keep on going. In verse 3, it says, He will not suffer thy foot to be moved. He that keep thee will not slumber. So if He is keeping you, just trust in Him. He is not sleeping. He is on the throne, and He is watching over the very affairs of your house. He is watching over the very affairs of your family. He's watching over the very affairs of everything that's going on in this world. Hallelujah. Oh, we thank You. Thank You. Thank You. We thank You. I could just imagine the reason why He says, behold, he that keeps Israel shall not neither slumber nor sleep. Because I remember when the disciples were in the boat, and the storm came upon them, and when the boat was getting rocked left and right, and they went to the master, and they thought the master was sleeping, and they woke him up, and they said, Master, Master, hallelujah, do you care if we die? Hallelujah, you're there sleeping, and our master, he was in control of everything. So no matter if it doesn't look, hallelujah, feasible, just trust in the Lord your God with all your heart. Hallelujah. Oh, we are so thankful. We're thankful because verse 6 of Psalms 121 says, the sun shall not smite thee by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord shall preserve thee from all evil. He shall preserve thy soul. I want to let somebody know that no matter the evil that is upon on you. Almighty God, my God is gonna keep you. My God is able to keep you from falling. My God is able. He is more than. And you got to believe and trust that when you are a servant of God, you are more than when you're in Him. Because, hallelujah, the scripture said that I am more than a conqueror through Him. Hallelujah. So that you, because you trust Him and because you serve Him and because you put your faith and your confidence in Him, you got to understand that you are more than a conqueror. So no matter what it looks like, you're more than a conqueror. No matter the army that comes up against you, and no matter everything that comes up against you, no matter when sickness comes up against you, you got to know that you are more than a conqueror. And verse 8 says, the Lord shall preserve thy going out and thy coming in from this time forth and evermore. Hallelujah. So you got to trust the Lord with everything that's going on, even in the midst of this pandemic and even in the midst of quarantine and even in the midst of persecution and struggles and torment and sickness and these type of things, having that confidence in Him, that knowing that when you step forth out that house or out this house, that your God is going to keep you. Almighty God, oh, we trust you. You see, while we are waiting, we must learn. There's some things that we have to learn. We have to learn, hallelujah, to dwell in our secret places. Pastor, what is our secret place? What are you talking about? What are you talking about? What are you talking about? Your secret place. You got to learn, hallelujah. You know, one of the things that this pandemic has taught us is that, you know, some of us have been so reliant on going to church and gathering of the brethren. It's wonderful, but we've been so reliant on the pastor praying for us and laying hands on us and all of our woes and everything is gone. But the one thing that this pandemic and this quarantine has taught us is that, you know, we can't be in a building. Some of us, we weren't able to go to church for 2 or 3 months, but we were able to pray. You know, we had to learn how to pray for ourselves, and we have to learn how to lay our hands on ourselves and to, you know, get a bottle of olive oil and to anoint it on ourselves and to touch ourselves and to pray over the things, the affairs of yourself and your life and your livelihood and your family. So one of the things that we have learned in this pandemic is to trust God and to believe Him, and knowing that, you know, it once you trust Him, you don't pick it up. I want to encourage somebody, hallelujah. We're talking about the art of waiting. We're talking about waiting on the Lord. Oh, the psalmist says, wait on the Lord and be of good courage. He says, so when you wait on the Lord, you know, some of the times we're waiting, but we are timid and we are fearful and we are wondering and we're this. And that's human. That's human. How could I be of good courage when I'm waiting? How could I, you know, not be at that place where I feel disappointment and I feel, you know, anxiety and I feel fear and I feel depression? How could I? And this is when you got to be able to get yourself in that secret place in your closet and be able to pray over yourself and not only pray, but trust and believe that your God is listening. Thank you, Jesus. We got to be able, while you are waiting, to dwell in your secret places. You got to be able to find your prayer closets. Find your closet where you can put away everything, lock away everything, that every distraction and everything that is there to steal your focus and to steal you. You know, turn the television off, turn the phones off and just get to that place where you just have that communion, one-on-one conversation with the Almighty God. Have a little talk with Jesus, as the songwriter says. Tell him all about your troubles. He will hear your faintest cries. He will answer by and by. Hallelujah. We got to get to that place, saints. Our secret closet, our secret places, our war rooms. Because the battle that we are facing, we can't just go into it haphazardly. We got to get to that place where we know how to fight our battles. And for some of us, hallelujah, for all of us, the victory is going to be won on our knees. The victory is going to be won when we're laying on our bellies and crying out to God. Oh, crying out to God for some of the things that we're facing and we're dealing with. Crying out to God for our children. Crying out to God for our spouses. Crying out to God for our mothers and our fathers, oh, our sons, our daughters, crying out to God. I can tell you, I am a product of prayer. I am a prayer of crying out to God. I would not be in this place today if it had not been for my mother, if it had not been for my father, just laying out in the midnight hours when I was out and about doing my own thing, and I would come into the house and I would be so fearful because my mother was, well, she was walking around the house and she was lifting up the praise and covering all of the children. And I would just walk in the house and I would feel the anointing. I would feel the presence of God. Oh, hallelujah. We got to get back to that place when we, hallelujah, cover our children, hallelujah, regardless of what you feel and your belief. You got to cover them, hallelujah. Oh, I'm thankful. I'm reminded of Job, and Job would lay up sacrifices for his children, and not that they were doing anything, but he would lay up sacrifices for them just in case they sinned. Waiting, the art of waiting. We got to learn these principles when we are waiting. We're talking about the art of waiting on the Lord. We're talking about prayer, going to God in prayer and making your petition be made known unto him. And you have to have confidence. So you got to go with prayer, praising him, hallelujah, praise and worship unto him. But you got to go in his throne room boldly, knowing that my God is able. And some of the times what we do is we lay our troubles at the altar. We lay it at the altar. We bring it before God and we say, here it is, Almighty God. But we don't leave it at the altar. Oh, hallelujah. We're talking about the art of waiting, the things that we have to learn, the things that we have to do while we are yet waiting. We have to make sacrifices. We have to make sacrifice. We have to sacrifice some things. We have to put away some things while we are waiting, in order for God to do something in this season. We have to put away some things. We have to make a sacrificial offering, and it's not only monetary offerings and sacrifices, but we're talking about the sacrifices of our time. We're talking about the art of waiting. Because surely he shall deliver thee from the snares of the fowler and from the noisome pestilence. Hallelujah. Do you believe and do you trust God that he will deliver you, that he will keep you, that he will sustain you, that he will provide for you? Do you believe God when you pray? We're talking about the things that we do while we are yet waiting. The Bible says, when we go on, it says, he shall cover thee with his feather, and under his wing shall thou trust. You should have trust. Trust. We're talking about wings. We're talking about eagles. We're talking about, you know, one of the, I love eagles. E-A-G-L-E-S, eagles. I love eagles. And this is probably one of the reasons why I became an Eagles fan. He shall cover thee with his feathers, and under his wings shall you trust. Under his wings. So when he covers you under his wings, you got to know that you are protected, that you are covered. His truth shall be thy shield and buckler. Thou shalt not be afraid for the terror by night. You see, when you're covered, when you trust him, while you're waiting on him, you should not be afraid, nor the arrow that flieth by day, nor the pestilence that walketh in darkness, nor the destruction that wasteth at noonday. Because verse 7 says, 1,000 shall fall at thy side, and 10,000 at thy right hand, but it shall not come nigh you. This is the confidence that you have while you are yet waiting, knowing that he is going to keep you protected. He's going to keep you covered. He's going to keep you saved. He's going to keep you sheltered. He's going to shelter you when you are in your storm. He's going to cover you. This is the confidence that we have. Hallelujah, that he will keep us. Talking about the art of waiting. You know, because right now, while we are yet talking about these things, you know, some of us are going through our season of dryness. Some of us are going through the season of disappointment. Some of us are going through the season of drought. Some of us are going through a season, hallelujah. We've never seen anything like this. And if God doesn't do it, and God doesn't keep us, if God doesn't protect us, hallelujah, we will be lost. We're talking about the art of waiting. Hallelujah. When we look at this text, I just wanted to draw a few things out of this text. You know, when we're talking about Isaiah 40 and 31, you know, when Isaiah reveals this in this passage of scripture, you know, he was appointed to be the prophet. He was one of the prophets, hallelujah, in the time of the kingdom of Jerusalem and the north kingdom and the southern kingdom, and when they were split, that's another teaching in all in itself. Hallelujah. But he this prophet Isaiah is prophesying to Israel in the midst of their trials and in their tribulation. And I truly believe that Isaiah, as relevant as this word was then, hallelujah, so many years ago, the word is still relevant now, because right now we are going through the midst of trials and tribulations, that we're going through this, and we're going through pandemic, COVID-19, and all kind of different things, and, you know, the elections, and all kind of Babylonian society and system that we are facing and we are dealing with. But just as how it was relevant then, the word still is relevant now. Hallelujah. We may not have kings, but we have people that wants to big themselves up as kings. The Bible says, hallelujah, before I even get there, hallelujah, when you look at this topic, when you look at the scripture, hallelujah, Isaiah, the prophet Isaiah, is prophesying in the time of King Hezekiah of Judah, king of Judah. And they were in the midst of an Assyrian crisis. And even though they were in the midst of the Assyrian crisis, you know, and a lot of these things, you know, happened because the children of Israel, because the kingdom did not wait on the Lord. They aligned themselves with different things, and they aligned themselves with false prophets, and they aligned themselves with idolatry and idolatry worship, and they aligned them things, ascribing to the things of God, but also, you know, ascribing to the things of men and pretty much trying to mix the two things together to come up with this magic portion. And when God says, look, I will fight your battle for you, you got to trust and believe that if God says it, he is going to do it. He is going to come through for you. But they had their doubts. They had doubts. God says, stand still. I'll fight this battle for you. I'll deal with them. And one king says, hey, look, I know you said that, but I want to align up with this other king, and I want to align up with this different army to fight the battle. And I, for sake of time, and it's so deep, and there's so many things when you look, hallelujah, at Isaiah and the kings, and First King and Second Kings, and there's so many things that you can unpack. You can see all of the inner working and the mixing from the different kings and the different prophets and how they aligned. But we're focusing right now on Isaiah. We're talking about the great prophet Isaiah that, you know, gave the revelation or gave the prophecy that Jesus Christ was going to come. Wonderful Counselor, Prince of Peace. We're talking about that Isaiah that gave that prophecy. Hallelujah. We're talking about the same Isaiah that Jesus Christ was able to open up his scroll and was able to read from what Isaiah said. In the midst of the Assyrian crisis, the angel of the Lord slew all of the Assyrian army and gave them the victory. In the middle of, and we're talking about in the middle, we're talking about waiting on the Lord. And I want to declare that in the middle of what we are facing, that my God will send forth something, someone. He will send forth his spirit. That whatsoever it is that we are facing, whatsoever that we are dealing with, we're talking about the art of waiting. They were still to face the Babylonian exile. But the same God who gave them the victory, the same God who would dwell within them and dwell with them. We're talking about the art of waiting. And when we look at the children of Israel, we can go all the way back. We can go back to when Joseph went to Egypt and he brought his family up there, and Egypt wasn't a place meant for them to stay. Hallelujah. And when Egypt saved them being able to interpret the dream and being able, Joseph being second to the Pharaoh. Hallelujah. And Joseph, the whole life of Joseph, would, if we would want something to glean from as something or someone that's a good example of waiting, would be Joseph. Because Joseph was a man that was thrown in, he was beloved by his father, and because of that, you know, his brothers hated him, and you know, that's another story for another time, that's another sermon for another time. But he was thrown in the pit, and he was taken out of the pit, he was sold into slavery, and down the line, we know Joseph had these powerful dreams, and he had the gift of interpretation, and he dreamt these dreams. Joseph might have been 10, 11, 12, 30, whatever the age he might have been at that time, and he dreamt the dreams, and he probably was wondering, my God, when will these dreams come through? We're talking about the art of waiting. And when he revealed the dreams to his brothers and how they felt they were intimidated, and they were filled with rage and hate for Joseph, all because of his dreams. And we're talking about the same Joseph that found favor in the house. Hallelujah. And for some reason, Joseph just looked different. He walked different. He talked different. And because of that, he found favor. They placed Joseph in charge. We're talking about Joseph, Potiphar's wife went after him. And he said, how could I do such a thing, and sin against my God? He believed in his integrity. We're talking about the Joseph that was thrown in prison for being falsely accused, but he was caught. He was caught in something that he did not even do. We're talking about having an evidence of something and you weren't even there. His coat was left behind, but it was not Joseph. And he was thrown in prison, but Joseph had to wait while yet in prison. We're talking about the art of waiting and people that had to wait for some things to be manifested and for some things to come to pass in their life. We're talking about Mary. She had to wait to see her son, the son that the everything that was pointing to. She got the dream and the vision that said she was going to have a son. His name was going to be Jesus and he would become the Messiah. And Mary had to wait. And not that when we look at even Mary, even Jesus had to wait, because when we look at the Bible and we read the Bible tells us, at one particular time, Joseph, he opened up the scroll, he read the scroll, and then we almost didn't even, the Bible for a stretch of time, we don't see anything again in the Bible about Jesus, but then it comes back when he came to the sea, hallelujah, hallelujah, and he was to be baptized, and he called for his cousin to baptize him. And Jesus' ministry started at the age of 30. We're talking about people that had to wait. We're talking about people in the Bible that had to wait. We're talking about the woman with the issues of blood. She had to wait. And the Bible says that she went and she spent all of her money and she could not find help. She could not find refuge. And she just grew weaker and weaker and weaker. We're talking about the woman with the issue of blood. And she had to wait. We're talking about the art of waiting, but she seized the opportunity. There was a moment when she heard that just this man, Jesus, was in town, and she believed that now was the time for her deliverance. We're talking about the art of waiting. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, I just want to encourage somebody that in the midst of your situation, you might have waited, oh, hallelujah, 12 years or 13 years or however long that you are waiting. You might have waited a month or 2 months, but I want to encourage somebody just to wait on the Lord and be of good courage. Oh, thank you, Jesus, because Psalms 27, hallelujah, says, the Lord is the light of my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? When the wicked, even my enemies and my foes came up on me to eat up my flesh, they stumbled and fell. So you got to believe that when you are waiting, in the midst of your waiting, that the Lord is the light of your salvation. While you are waiting, you will not fear, because the Lord is the strength of your life. I want to encourage somebody, don't be fearful. Don't be fearful of the naysayers. Don't be fearful of those that ridicule you. Don't be fearful of those, hallelujah, that wants to throw you off course, and those that want to discourage you, those that want to distract you. I want to encourage somebody to wait upon the Lord. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Oh, come on, bless the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Oh, we magnify your name. We magnify your name. We magnify your name. Oh, we thank you, Jesus, for those and hosts, should encamp against me, my heart shall not fear. Though war should rise against me, in this will I be confident. You got to have that confidence. You got to be able to put
your chest up, hallelujah, not boasting in yourself, but boasting in God and knowing that you have this confidence in God. Oh, and the psalmist says, one thing am I desire of the Lord that I will seek after, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to behold the beauty of the Lord and to inquire in his temple. Come on, you got to bless him. You got to bless the name of Jesus. You got to get to that place, hallelujah, where you make a joyful noise unto the Lord and serving him with gladness. Hallelujah. You make a joyful noise, not knowing what the outcome is, but knowing the person that is in the midst of the outcome and knowing that he will take you through. All you have to do is seek him. All you have to do is trust him. All you have to do is believe in him. Come on, we're talking about the art of waiting. And I know one four-letter word that some of us, hallelujah, don't like to hear too much. And while we are yet waiting, we got to get to that place where we fast. Where we fast. We fast for some things, fast from some things, hallelujah. You need a spiritual awakening. You need to be drawn closer to God in this season and in this time, hallelujah. As we, 2020 is wrapping up and is winding down. Some things did not go as we planned, but hallelujah, you got to get yourself ready and geared up for 2021, believing and trusting even right now in the now that 2021 should be your greater. But even if it doesn't go like that, you still are going to trust God. We're talking about fasting. We're talking about the art of waiting. So we're talking about praying and praising, worshiping, and having confidence in him. And then fasting. Some things that we face and some of the things that we deal with are not going to go out but by fasting. And I know it's hard, you know, because the moment when you start to fast, is this is when you're most, you know, hungry, because the flesh longs after the things of the flesh and it yearns and it lusts after the things of the flesh. And I know even for myself, I can go one full day without eating a meal and I'm not fasting, but the moment that I said I'm going to sacrifice myself a fast unto God, because there's some things that I need to see change. There's some breakthrough that I need to see in my life. They come, they bring donuts and they bring all these different things and the good cake. And you're being tried. You're being tested. Talking about the art of waiting. I wonder if anyone is getting this in their spirit. I'm not able to interact because I'm using a different broadcasting software. So I'm not able to really interact or to see what's going on or to see any comments or to see anything that you know, whoever is on. But I'm just hoping that this is encouraging someone today. Even though you may be going through, you're going through. Wait. Wait on the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Wait on the Lord. Hallelujah. Oh, I magnify your name. Even if you're at your Red Sea, you got to learn how to wait. We're talking about the art of waiting. You know, and I alluded to this last week when the children of Israel, they were at their Red Sea, you know, and the children of Israel, they know about waiting. Bible says that after Joseph went to Egypt and he brought his family, the children of Israel, they were in Egypt, and they came a Pharaoh that did not know Joseph. And the children of Israel, they were growing in, by numbers and just enormously, just outrageously, just growing and multiplying and multiplying and multiplying. And then they rose up against them and they said, hey, look, you know, we need to put these people under subjection. Don't you see that they will outnumber us? And so they had taskmasters over them, controlling every aspect of their lives. And the Bible said that they over 400 years, over 400 years, they were in bondage, and they cried out aloud. They cried out to the Father. They said, you know, they cried for freedom. They some died. Many died after 400 years, and they were enslaved. But here comes Moses, sent and directed by God to go down to Pharaoh's house and to declare to Pharaoh, let my people go. If they ask, who sent me? Who shall I say sent me? Tell them I am. Tell them I am sent you. I want to encourage somebody today. I want to encourage somebody today, and I hope I'm encouraging somebody today, because we all are waiting for something. We're all waiting for this pandemic to be over. We're all waiting for the presidency. Some are waiting for the presidency to be over, for the new regime to take over. We're waiting for 2021. We're waiting for this. We're waiting for that. But what are you doing in the midst of your waiting? Are you trusting? Are you praying? Are you fasting? What are you doing? We're talking about the art of waiting. You might be at your Red Sea, but you got to believe that your God is going to see you through. And I love this thing. Sister Donna put this up during the course of this week and says, stand still and see the salvation of the Lord. For the Egyptian you see today, tomorrow you see them no more. With Pharaoh chasing you down, with the bills, with the this, with the that, with the isms and the schisms of life beating you and pressing you left and right, I want to encourage somebody to get deeper in God, deeper in God, deeper. Grow deeper in God. Read the word of God. Hallelujah. You may be riddled with pains in your bodies. Your back may be against the wall. But I will say of the Lord, he is my refuge and strength. I wonder if anybody can boldly declare that you are my refuge and my strength. I'm sorry, I get so emphatic when I talk. talk about the word of God. But you are my refuge and strength. Sometimes you got to use God's word back to him and let him know, hallelujah, what his word says. Your word says that no weapon formed against me shall prosper. Isaiah 54:17. Your word tells me that the weapons of my warfare, they're not carnal, but mighty through God in the pulling down of stronghold. So the weapon that we are warring with, and that's a topic for next week, hopefully, is they're not carnal, but they're mighty through God in pulling down a stronghold. So when you face stronghold, you got to learn how to fight. The art of waiting involves praying, involves filling yourself with spiritual things. Praise and worship, the scripture, the Bible, praying, fasting, but being of good courage. I wonder if I'm helping someone. I will say of the Lord, he is my refuge. He is a mighty God. He's a strong tower. In him will I put my trust. As I stated before, the weapons of our warfare, they're not carnal, but are mighty through God in the pulling down of stronghold. Do you want to see some change in your life? You just got to get to that place where you're radical enough to believe and to trust and to, you know, to step out beyond the realms of what you can see. Walk by faith and not by sight. You got to get to that place where, you know, what you say, you know, you just get crazy and you say, I will bless the Lord at all times. His praises shall continually be in my mouth. At all times. All means all. That means when you're going through, you will bless him. When you're on the mountaintop, you bless him. When you're in the valley, you bless him. When you're standing before your Red Sea, you bless him. When the bills are due, you bless him. And I know it sounds crazy. I know, you know, like, you pastor, you, what are you saying? How could I bless him when I'm facing all of these things? But you got to get to that place where you praise him through your circumstances, through your situation, through your downtime, through your hurt, through your pain. Hallelujah. You just got to confuse your enemy, because when your enemy is already planning for your demise, planning for your funeral, and you just come in laughing and talking and shouting and praising, you know, he's confused by it. How could you praise after all that you're going through? How could you praise after all that you've been through, after all the struggles, after everything that the enemy, all the obstacles that's been in your way? How? But I'm just so thankful that even in the midst of your season of drought, even in the midst of your crisis, there is a Christ in your crisis. There's a Christ that you can trust while you're in your crisis. He says that they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They that wait upon the Lord. It's a criteria. They that wait. We're talking about the art of waiting. Talking about waiting on the Lord. We're talking about trusting in the Lord. That's what we're talking about. Hallelujah. We thank you, Jesus. Wait on the Lord. For they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. And so many times, hallelujah, we are in a place when we feel weary, when we feel burdened down, when we feel let down, when we feel cast down. But we got to get to that place where we can say, my soul doth magnify the Lord, and my spirit praises his name. Hallelujah. You got to get to that place where you're saying, hear my cry, O Lord, and attend unto my prayer. From the end of the earth will you cry out unto me. When my heart is overwhelmed, lead me to the rock that is higher than I. They that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run. They shall run. I want to tell somebody that when you wait upon the Lord, that you shall run. You shall run and not be weary. You shall walk and not faint. I want to tell somebody that you should not be weary in well-doing, because my God is going to show up. I saw this morning or yesterday. Oh, but when, hallelujah, somebody put up on Facebook, oh, isn't it great that even when, if God is 4 days late, he is still on time. He's an on-time God. Yes, he is. He may not come when you are thinking that he should come, but he will show up right on time. For they that wait up on the Lord shall renew their strength. Oh, I want to encourage somebody this morning that no matter where you are and no matter what you are facing, I want to tell somebody, hallelujah, that you should wait upon the Lord and trust in him, believing in him, and knowing that he is going to show up on time. Just like an eagle, when he learns how to fly, and when he's learning how to fly, oh, the mother will take him up very high, and he will let that eagle go, and the eagle will start to fall and fall and fall at a rapid pace, and he's flapping around and he's trying, but he can't get anything. He can't get his wings. He can't get his wings flowing. He can't get his wings. He can't get the air under his wings. Oh, hallelujah. But just in that nick of time when he's about to go and he's about to crash and he's about to hit the floor, oh, hallelujah, mommy eagle would rise up and will pick him up. Oh, just in a nick of time, and he will take him up to another plane, another highness, and he will let him go again. He will let him go, and he will be flopping around, and he'll be trying to fly, and he's falling, and he's falling, and he's falling, and just before he hits the ground, the eagle will pick him up and take him to a new highness again. Hallelujah. And I want to declare that the season that you're in is to strengthen your wings. You may not know, you may not feel it, you may not understand the season that you are dealing with in your life, the season that you're dealing with in your family, the season that you're dealing with in your health and your finances, the season that you're dealing with even right now. But hallelujah, oh, Father God will pick you up right before you crash and you burn. I'm decreeing and I'm declaring that. Oh, because the eagle will take his baby up again. Oh, hallelujah. And this time, with everything that the baby eagle was trying before, he lets him go and he starts flattering and starts trying to find his way. But just in the nick of time, he goes and he gets the hang of it, and he starts to soar on his own. Those they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. Father God, we thank you. Father God, we worship you. Father God, hallelujah.
as we are here on today, Lord God. I don't know all of who's on this line, or who's live today, Lord God, hallelujah. I don't know all that is lacking and all that is needed, Lord God, hallelujah. But one thing that I do know, that you have some people that's here, Lord God, hallelujah. That need you, Lord. They need you. They need you. They need you. They feel like throwing in the towel, and they feel like giving up. They feel like all hope is lost. They feel, Lord God, and why have I been forsaken, Almighty God? I've been in church all my life, hallelujah. My mother's been in church all of her life. My father's been in church all of his life, hallelujah. I've done all the right things. I may not have smoked, went to parties, drunk, and acted a fool, but Almighty God, here I am, Lord God, and I'm wondering why. Why, Almighty God, I paid my tithe, I've sowed seeds, I've given to the poor, Almighty God, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. And Father God, I'm in need of you, Lord God, I'm in need of a breakthrough, I'm in need of a miracle, Lord God. Spirit of the living God, fall afresh right now, Almighty God. Those that are in Facebook land, hallelujah, hallelujah. Those are in need, hallelujah, of a transplant of a Lord God, hallelujah, hallelujah. Only you can do it, Lord. Only you can fix it. Only you can make that which, Lord God, hallelujah, needs to be made new. Only you can do it, Almighty God. If you can't fix it, no one can. But can you fix it? Yes, you can. And we are trusting in you, Lord God. You are our refuge. You are our strength. Almighty God, we are crying out to you, Lord God. Oh, Lord God, knowing that you are well able, Lord, knowing that you are able to do exceedingly abundantly above all we can ask or think, knowing, Lord God, hallelujah. Oh, Father God, hallelujah, that we've been still, oh, Lord God, hallelujah, waiting on you, Lord God, waiting for your goodness to overshadow and overtake us, Lord God. Oh, Father God, waiting, Lord God, hallelujah. Waiting, Lord God, and knowing, Lord God, that you are good, because we have seen it, Lord God, from time to time, knowing that you are good, Lord God. But Father God, we are in need. We are in need. We are in need, Lord God. We're in need of a spiritual breakthrough. We're in need of a miracle, Lord God. We're in need of an awakening on today, Lord God. Oh, Father God, some of us, the doctors have given up on us and said, oh, Lord God, hallelujah, that there's nothing else that they can do, Lord God. But Father God, the scripture says, whose report shall we believe, Lord God? And Father God, we choose to believe your word, and we choose to believe your report, Lord God, knowing, Lord God, that when you in the vessel, Lord God, with you, Lord God, hallelujah, we can get through everything, Lord God, knowing, Lord God, that you're Jehovah Jireh, the God that provides, knowing, Lord God, that you are the Alpha, knowing, Lord God, that you are the Omega, knowing that you are the beginning and the end, knowing that you're the first and the last, knowing, Lord God, that you're the fierce of 10,000, knowing, Lord God, hallelujah, that in you, Lord God, we move, we breathe, we have our being, knowing in you, Lord God, hallelujah, we shall be the head and not the tail, knowing, Lord God, hallelujah, that in you, Lord God, hallelujah, all fears are gone. Knowing, Lord God, because your word declares and it dictates, Lord God, that you are not man, that you should lie, nor son of man, that you should repent. Knowing, Lord God, that even
Oh, Father God, if we're facing, financial hardship and burden, Lord God, that a cattle on a thousand hill belongs unto you, Lord God, knowing, Lord God, hallelujah, that you, Lord God, are the God that gives good gifts. Knowing, Lord God, hallelujah, that if we ask you for fish, you will not give us serpent. Knowing, Almighty God, if we ask you for bread, you will not give us stone. Knowing, Lord God, hallelujah, and Father God, we cry out unto you, Lord God, just as the psalmist, Lord God, hallelujah, said, this poor man cried, and you, God, heard him and delivered him from all of his fears, Lord God, knowing, Lord God, that while we yet wait on you, Lord God, that we can see things and good things while yet in the land of the living, knowing, Almighty God, that we will wait upon you and be of good courage, Lord God, knowing that we're trusting in you with all our heart, knowing, Lord God, that in you we're more than a conqueror. We're talking about the art of waiting. As we get ready for Thanksgiving, I just want to encourage somebody on today. I want to thank those that have donated and have sown seeds into this Thanksgiving drive, and just to give you guys a synopsis of where we are with the Thanksgiving drive. Right now, my freezer is filled with turkey. Of about 17 turkeys in my freezer right now. 2 turkeys in another freezer. So that's 19 turkeys. We have about 10 more turkeys that are promised. The goals, so that's about 29 to 30 turkeys. The goal is to feed 50 families Thanksgiving, to provide them with groceries. Yesterday, a good friend, Brother Albin, we went to supermarket and blessed us with some trimmings and stuff while we're yet collecting for this drive.